Alright, this is an Origins 6222 Swiss draft. The format's pretty well developed by this time. But Jace is sitting at 75 tickets, and I want to have a go at at grabbing him. So I'm going to try to do that through these Swiss drafts to see if I can pick up a Jace every approximately 10 drafts or 20 drafts to even out the expense of the drafting or possibly profit a small amount. I'm going to pause it and I'll start it back up once the queue is filled. I don't like the screen size at the moment. I think here you take the Dijin. The Starfish is also good, though I think this is the right pick. I like green-blue. I like blue-red. I like blue-black. Valorous Wardens is a strong card. Leaf Gilder is a strong card as well. I think I'm going to go with the Valoron Wardens and just see where this goes. Okay, we're third pick in now. And there's some fairly... there's two good white cards right in the front, as well as a third Leaf Gilder. I might end up in green-white. I'm going to take the Swift Reckoning here. With Leaf Gilder would probably be my second choice. Huh. A second Valoron Wardens definitely makes this stronger. I think that it's a pretty clear pick. And again, we can see that green is probably open. The Amperin Tactician is also decent. Water Courser is fair, but this is a better card. Anchor to the Aether is, in my opinion, a really strong card. It's better than the cards that normally just put Unsummoned to the top of the deck and that it scries. And there's nothing really else here for me. Consecrated by Blood is a good card as well, but we're nowhere near that, so maybe green blue splash white. In that case, I'd want to pick up this Evolving Wilds. Might of the Masses is a good card as well. Kytheon's Tactics we wouldn't play in a splash, so I'm going to take the Evolving Wilds. I'll try to pause between the long delays. Looks like we're waiting on player one. Not a lot here for me. Really haven't found a use for this card in this format. I mean, I guess it's intended to go with the blue black scab, and then maybe cards like Revenant and Macabre Waltz and the Reanimate card. I'm going to pick the Charging Griffin, although Fastwood Gorger is fine. I think the Griffin is better. The problem with Elemental Bond is that it really never triggers. There's like nothing that triggers it. Oromancer with maybe like some encrusts. Gather the pack. Card's fine. I'm gonna take the Might of the Masses. It's a pretty good combat trick in certain situations. It's also a win condition. Prism Ring would not see play. Aether Grid might see play in someone's deck, though it's unlikely. Here, I think I'm gonna go with this. Demolish, auto pick, and a mountain. Alright, come on, Jace. Which is all I say every time I draft ORI, but one can hope. That's an interesting card. I really like this card, though for where I'm at, I think the Thunderclap Wyvern is better. I only intend to splash white. I'll likely end up with a number of solid flyers. Here's a free blade. I still think this is the better pick. If I was deeper white, I would probably take this. It's a great card, really. If it allows you to keep two mana hands, this first striker, it's a solid card. This is okay as well. I'm going to go with the Wyvern. So there's some mana fixing. Should I want to splash black as well? But I don't think that I do. So here I think I would want to take like this Cleric. The Drake. That's it, really. So it's between the Cleric and the Drake. I'm gonna go with the Drake. Red and white land. I think these are worth one ticket each. Let's see. .86. The card I'd be passing up for it would be Scrap Skin Drake or Negate or Fiery Conclusion, but I'm going to go ahead and take it. So here I have to choose between Totem Guide Harp Beast or a Tower Geist. I'm just going to take the Tower Geist. Primarily because of the Thunderclap Wyvern, although I do like the ability to draw a card. I like it more when it's in a flying package, though. I know that a pick like this, it's at the very least it's offensive to some people, but the thing about it is it's a swish draft, and being able to make up a couple of tickets can mean the difference between drafting again for free or not, so I pick them up when I can. Okay, here I could take a Rock Smaller or a Titanic Growth. They're both good. I already have 10 creatures. I think I'll go with the trick. I like this card, though it doesn't fit in this deck. It is kind of scary, however. Despoiler of Souls, I think I've decided, is bad. It just doesn't do enough. Jessian Thief is solid. Aspiring Aeronaut is good, primarily, well, it's good on its own, but it's especially good with this. The question is, would the card draw be better? I'm leaning towards this. Aeronauts can usually be picked up. Here, Hydra Lash is not bad. I don't mind a card like this. It's like a weak fog and you draw a card. It preps spell mastery. But this is important for sideboard, although I'm willing to mainboard it as well. Disperse? Or another Drake? I'll take the trick. Gather the pack. It's okay. Take a Bone Dash. Here I'll take the Artificer's Epiphany. Although I don't have any artifacts. So maybe that's, well, it doesn't matter. Unique card also. Artifacts or not, you have to take it. I'll pick up a Negate. Second Negate. Hey, see? Nice last pick, Aeronaut. Alright. Time to start cutting stuff. I don't really need that. I like it so far. I'd like to pick up one more Evolving Wilds. Or maybe a Yavimaya Coast. But I like it so far. I probably won't play the Charging Griffin. So again, open no money. Pile Driver is okay in certain decks, but you really have to have a lot of goblins. Reef Soul is good. Fairy Miscreant is also good in my deck. I'm going to try for the Miscreant, and I hope to pick up one or two more. Really, two more. Aromancer is not going to make the cut, because I didn't get Encrust. Question then is, do I still splash white, but I guess because of the Wyvern, you're kind of forced to. It improves the quality of your creatures so much. And if you get a second, which can happen, it's also very good. I gather the pack won't get played. Wow, foil Liliana. Can't imagine what they passed up. They must have had a Jace. So I'll take the foil Liliana. That's funny. What's she worth? Oh, not much at all. Only 7. So they must have had a Jace. They passed me the 7 because they took the 70. I like Timber Pack Wolves, but I don't have any. A second Jesse and Thief is pretty solid, I think. Card's fine. It's just a 2-drop though in my deck. I don't have any enchantments. So is there something else I'd like to play? A Meteorite? I kind of like that Meteorite. It's so expensive though at 5 mana. I'll take the 2-drop. This is a good card. One of the benefits of green-blue is you can pick up this Crassus very late, and it's a very strong drop. I mean, it can give you tempo by tapping down a creature on their turn. It can act as pseudo removal by untapping one of your good blockers and putting a flash creature on the board, so it's really solid. There's another Disperse and a Separatist Void Mage, but this is the pick. This card, if they are able to get it to Renown, which, because it has haste, it's not that hard to do, it's kind of annoying. It'll end up pinging you for 2, 4, even 6 damage before you can deal with it. My only other pick here is Clash of Wills, but I'm just going to take this. I don't want to deal with that card. I don't really need the Clash of Wills. Here's a second Miscreant, which is good for me. Psychic Rebuttal is just a sideboard card. And this is a nice looking deck. Not bad at all. I'd take another Fairy Miscreant. I could put the Caterpillar in the sideboard. I'll cut the Gather the Pack. This is a good deck. That Foil Liliana is a nice boon. Because she's so low, what I'm going to do is probably just hold on to her. A foil mythic is likely to rise in cost as this set rotates out and is no longer drafted. At least until it can no longer be redeemed. But as they become more and more rare, for redemption purposes, they go up, sometimes pretty starkly. Shrouding Mist, I think, is what I take here. It's playable. It's good. Anytime you can get a one mana trick, it can do a lot of work. They're easy to cast. They aren't really expected. I'm sure I would have picked up like one more Leaf Gilder. But that's alright. I have good card draw. This is Pilgrimage. It's interesting. It's not really a good card, but it does thin, and it does ramp, although I'm only ramping to 5, so I guess it's not necessary. I'm going to take this. Phone's ringing, so I'm going to reserve the Revenant. I'll be right back. How much of the stuff are you looking to sell? Okay, sorry about the little bit of chatter and lack of talk at the end, though. Those picks were pretty much automatic. I'm at a shop, my friend's comic shop right now, in the back room, and a guy called about selling a collection, so I took his call. But this deck is pretty much good to go as it is. Let me make sure that there's nothing missing. I actually like this deck. It's pretty solid. I mean, the highest mana cost is 5, but there's so many evasive creatures that it can really do some work. And then with the 2 Jessian Thieves and a couple of Miscreants, and Artificer's Epiphany, I should have no trouble drawing into my cards. The question, I guess, would be, do I want to cut the Enshrouding Mist for a safer blue trick? I probably will. I'll keep the Swift Reckoning, and I'll keep the Thunderclap Wyvern, but I think that without a second Evolving Wilds, this card doesn't really do enough. I'd rather have the Negate. But this is the deck, so I'll put it together and submit and start another video.